Didn't even see you come in. I was too busy doing science. You may be wondering where I'm doing science. Right now, I'm in Panama, where there's lots of insects. Amazing people. And science.
All of the research plots in Fortuna are 1 hectare in area. Right now we're in a plot called Quebrado Honda A. All the trees in this plot are censused every 10 years, and their genus, if not their species, is identified. And more importantly, their location is also identified. Some of the tasks that we do that I'm involved with this summer is the ongoing censusing of logs, leaf characterizations, we collect senescing leaves, tree banding for growth, and we also check the forest floor for new fungal growth. So we're doing something very fun right now. It is boring trees. So we measured the diameter around this tree, and it turned out to be 24 centimeters, so we set our bore to half that distance, 12 centimeters, and now I'm going to go in and take a little biopsy of this tree. So we're taking a woody sample right now, and we're going to measure the non-structural sugar being stored in the tree, and we're going to compare that to different trees in this plot at different elevations and different nutritional components in the soil. These first few turns are pretty delicate, but, and Katie, am I straight?
Okay. Yes.
So we're gonna take this woody sample and we're gonna take it back to the lab. It's very important to be perpendicular to the tree, so we get a nice, consistent, he's got much better vantage point than I do. Alright, so we're going to take the woody sample that we get from this tree, take it back to the lab, and boil off the glucose that's naturally stored in the tree. Then we're going to treat it with two enzymes, invertase and amylase, and react that with NAD and measure its conversion to NADH using a spectrometer. We're getting close. And that should be a good proxy for exactly how much sugar is being stored by the tree as non-structural starch. So I am all the way in. Oh, maybe a little bit more. I hear the tree screaming right now. I'm going to take this guy and I'm going to actually get my sample from inside the bore. This is the delicate part of the tree boring operation. Then, very, very carefully, I'm going to remove this because it's important to keep track of which side is towards the center of the tree that I'm taking.
Oh, okay.
Ah, magical. Perfect. And so now we're going to put this in the cooler and take it back to the lab. Tree growth can be measured using several different metrics. One of the most meaningful pieces of data comes from the dendrometer band. Let me move this liana so you can see a little better. It is just a piece of hard plastic and a spring, and it expands as the tree trunk expands and presumably grows. We have 100 trees in this plot that are banded, and 7 other plots at varying elevations and soil components. Such a large sample size is needed because there's a natural flux to the tree. It respires more at night, so the trunk shrinks, and depending on the amount of water, the cells are more turgid, and on a daily basis, there can be small fluctuations within the size of the tree. One of the more interesting parts of this research is comparing if there's a difference in growth rate between the two seasons in the rainforest, the wet season and the dry season. Another project that I'm involved with for STRI is the continual recensusing of log production on the forest floor. What we do is we mark a north-south transect throughout the plot and we walk it, which is kind of an adventure in itself. There's lots of bad terrain, tree fall, thorns, vines, insects. Actually, right now you can hear monkeys in the background, and that's very exciting. So, once we found a log, we take our wood caliper, and we call this guy Pato because he looks like a duck, and measure it along the exact point it intersects our transect. There you go. So, we enter this in to a calculation with the density of the wood, which we take using a penetrometer. And so, this penetrometer has been calibrated to 10 centimeters. And we go and we drop it a certain amount of times. This one's 26. And we use the density of the wood as a proxy for decomposition. So this is a litter fall basket. We have 8 in this plot. And from this litter fall basket, we collect periodically, either every 2 weeks or every month, depending on the plot. We take all the leaves, put it in a bag, and take it back to measure the total biomass being recycled by the trees. All right, so here we are, walking a transect in another Fortuna plot. This time we're looking for fungus, and so we're just walking this little blue line, I don't know if it comes across on the camera, and on 2 meters of either side of it, we look for new fungus growth, and then we take the mushroom and take it back to identify it, and then track over time how much fungus grows on the forest floor. Another one of our projects involves taking leaf characteristics from different trees in all of our plots. So sometimes they end up way up there, and so we get to use the pole pruner to bring them down. There we go. Get these as quickly as possible. So the pole pruner extends probably about 20 meters up, and has its own set of challenges. Once we get the leaves down, we take a few different characteristics, such as surface area, density, chlorophyll. There we go. Close enough. So, go up. What kind of leaves do you like? There we go, and we got a leaf. So we're in a unique part of the rainforest right now that is dominated by palm species. This is a very exciting project that we're doing. It is trying to measure the rate of growth of monocots, so these palm trees right here. We are attempting to estimate the rate of growth by judging the change in leaf scarring. So whenever a palm frond like this falls off of a tree, it leaves a scar, a leaf scar. And we can chart that year to year. This is the second year of the census. And use that to estimate the age of these woody monocots.